Transcribed.
From Hollywood, we present the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show. Brought to you by Dentine, the gum with breathtaking flavor. By Beeman's Pepsin, the gum that's great to chew and good for your digestion, too. By Chesterfield, sound off for Chesterfield. Get something new, something no other cigarette has. Chesterfield mildness plus no unpleasant aftertaste. And by Anison for fast relief from pain of headache, neuritis, and neuralgia. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to introduce our master of ceremonies.
Hiya, folks. This is Dean Martin. Friday has come over the horizon, and if you don't have a headache now, you will when my ear-splitting partner gets here. Anyway, while we're waiting for Nature Boy to arrive, let's kick around a brand new tune that I've just recorded. Richard?
To be loved is a thrilling sensation, as thrilling as can be. Though it happens in every nation, they greet it differently. Every mademoiselle whispers ooh la la la, every Englishman talks to his pater, every smitten Venetian goes tra la la la, and the Irish say Mother McCree. But when I look at you and I thrill like I do, there is only one thing I can say. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Oh boy, what a joy, a joy, a joy, a joy, a joy. To know that you love me, by heaven above me, I never expected to pick you off the vine.
The others will try and try and try and try and try to give you the eye, the eye, the eye, the eye, the eye.
But when they approach you, I'll keep them in line,
in line, in line,
by telling them, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, you're mine. Certain characters hide it a little when Cupid comes along. Some mechanics shift gears in the middle and drummers kick the gong. Every cowboy I know hollers yippee-yi-yi. Every clown in the circus goes oopla. Every sailor in port hollers anchors away, and an Indian it gives you the ah. But when you hold me tight like you're doing tonight, there is only one thing I can say. Oh boy, oh boy,
oh boy,
oh boy, oh boy,
oh boy,
oh boy. Oh boy, what a joy,
oh
a joy,
joy,
a joy,
oh
a joy, a joy. To know that you love me, by heaven above me, I never expected to pick you off the vine.
The others will try and try and try and try and try to give you the eye, the eye, the eye, the eye, the eye.
But when they approach you, I'll keep them
in line, in line,
in line, by telling them, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy,
oh boy, oh boy, oh boy,
oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, you're mine.
Thank you very much. Now, ladies and gentlemen, because my pleasure to introduce...
Hey, Dean, is this my cue to come out and be adorable?
Jerry, how many times must I tell you? You're supposed to come out when I'm through saying, Jerry Lewis.
Listen, Rodney. When you're through saying Jerry Lewis, I'm through coming out.
It's no use, Joe. Every show, it's the same thing. You act like an umbecile.
Yeah, well, I... Umbecile. For a minute, I thought he was wrong.
Now, Jerry, you keep it up. Go ahead, Jerry. Just keep it up, and one of these days, you're going to find a pink slip in your pay envelope.
Listen here, Dean Martin. Don't think you can tempt me with pretty unmentionable.
You know... I never cease to be amazed at the irrational elements contained in what I would call your insipid and exceptionally peculiar sense of humor.
That's right.
Dean Martin, you sly fox, you gave the writers Christmas presents.
Jerry, you seem pretty preoccupied with Christmas. It was almost a month ago and it's still on your mind. Why?
I like it.
You you haven't told me a word about your Christmas. Was it merry?
Yeah, it was merry.
Well, you care to tell me about it?
But I'd rather sing about it.
Be my guest.
It was the day after Christmas, and I had dreamt about nothing but the presents I was to get Christmas Day. Ha, ha, ha. The presents I was to get. Ha, 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 ha. The shirts were swell. The socks were fine. They're all size 10, but my feet are size 9. I've had a very merry Christmas. The watch won't run. The wallet's split. The gloves are small. The pajamas don't fit. I've had a very merry Christmas. 10 dozen hankies. A gift of anti-roses. 10 dozen hankies. She must think I'm all covered with noses. 6 neckties are all handmade. They're lovely ties, but they're all the same shade. Oh, I've had a very merry Christmas. Jingle bells, jingle bells, give my heart a lift. Tomorrow I'll be on my way, exchanging every gift. My heaven, fine time I had. The pen won't write, the slippers gap, the bathrobe's tight, and the camera won't snap. I've had a very merry Christmas. Those darn cigars are much too strong. The sweater's wide and the shorts are too long. I've had a very merry Christmas. 6 pairs of swim trunks, a present that my firm made. 6 pairs of swim trunks, they must think I am Minnie the Mermaid. And too small, the ring ain't gold. The muffler's thin, and I caught a good cold. Oh, I've had a very merry Christmas. Thank heavens, it's only once a year, boy. Thank heavens. Only once a year.
Well, now that Jerry and I have both had a chance to be in the spotlight, let's shine it on Jimmy Wallington.
Thanks, Dean. And now here's something of interest to everybody.
For breathless moments, for your breathless moments,
chew dentine, the gum with breathtaking flavor.
Dentine tastes so good.
Dentine freshens your breath.
Dentine helps keep your teeth sparkling clean and white.
Dentine, the gum with breathtaking flavor.
Before you go out and always after eating, drinking, smoking, refresh your breath with Dentine. You'll love Dentine chewing gum, for Dentine has a wonderful tingling, nippy flavor that lingers on and on. It's delicious. And remember, Dentine helps keep your teeth white, too. Keep Dentine handy. You'll enjoy refreshing your breath when you chew Dentine. So for breathless moments, for your breathless moments,
chew Dentine, the gum with breathtaking flavor.
Well, every once in a while, the gang at the recording company picks out a tune for me to sing, and I'm against it. And every once in a while, I pick out a tune, they're against it. The happiest time is when we pick out a tune and find ourselves in perfect accord. And that's the story of the number I'd like to sing now.
As you are, my love. As you are, my love. Say the years go by. heart will ever sigh. You're the love for me. Dearest, always be as you are to me. You're my guiding star. Love you are to me. My love you'll ever be. Though you're near or far, it's so clear to me why you're so dear to me. As you are, as you are, love you are to me. My love you'll ever be, though you're near or far. It's so clear to me why you're so dear to me. As you are, as you are.
I'm glad you liked the song.
I liked it too, Dean.
Well, thank you, Miss... Oh, for goodness sake, this is really an unexpected compliment. Folks, I want you to meet one of Hal Wallace's brightest and cutest actresses, Marion Marshall.
Thank you.
Well, Marion, what are you doing here?
I just dropped over to say goodbye. I'm going on a little trip.
Now, where are you going?
Well, I'm tucking a print of our new picture, Sailor Beware, in my suitcase, and I'm going on a 2-week tour of 11 Naval District Headquarters. I have a pretty important job to do. This trip is sponsored by the March of Dimes, and I'm going to do my best to let everyone know how important and vital their contributions are.
Well, you couldn't be talking about a worthier charity, Marion. The National Foundation for Infantile Paralysis needs the help of every person in this nation. Everything that's sent in is another step in the direction that may bring relief to the many thousands of sufferers. So, have a good trip, Marion, and here's hoping you start those dimes and dollars marching all over the country.
Thank you, Dean. Good night, folks.
Hey, Jer, did you see that new ad for Chesterfield?
Oh, you mean the one showing you and me dressed up as sailors, huh?
That's the one.
Yeah, I got a telegram from Washington. They said they were glad to see us in sailor suits.
Oh, a telegram from the Navy?
No, from the Army.
From the Army. No kidding, folks. You'll see Jerry and I in the new Chesterfield poster when you buy cigarettes. And we'll be telling you to sound off for Chesterfield just like this. We're sailors in our latest ad.
Our pants are tight, we sure look bad.
But man, to smokers we'll appeal.
Because we're holding Chesterfield.
Chesterfield, Chesterfield, Chesterfield,
Chesterfield.
Milder, 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 Chesterfield.
That's right.
Sailors, soldiers, all you folks can get the very best in smokes. Just change to Chesterfield today. Enjoy your smoking all the way.
Sound off.
For Chesterfield.
Sound off.
For Chesterfield, enjoy your smoking all the way with Chesterfield.
That's right!
Well, Ladies and gentlemen, our guest tonight is one of Hollywood's most popular character actors, Mr. Hans Conreid. One of Mr. Conreid's best characters is that of a blustering Englishman. And it just so happens that my partner Jerry is terribly impressed by very important Britishers. So, with your permission, I'd like to fool Jerry into thinking that Mr. Conreid is a famous English actor. Now, we'll see what happens. And, here's Jerry now. So, here goes. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, I'd like to present one of England's foremost actors, a man you've seen in countless British films. Here he is, Mr. John Newton.
Thank you, Mr. Martin. As I told you earlier, I've been exceedingly eager to appear on your program. I was told that if I were to meet Martin and Lewis, I would see living proof of the Darwinian theory that man has descended from the apes.
Well, maybe my partner can help you. Hey, Jeff, come here.
Yeah, what is it, Dean? I was...
Land o' Goshen, there's a stranger in our midst.
Thank you, Mr. Martin. Well, good night.
Oh, no, don't rush off, John. Well, why don't you ask Jerry what he thinks of the Darwin theory?
Well, I'd be happy to. Just as soon as he stops swinging his tail in my face.
All right, let's stop with the insults, buddy.
I don't even know you.
Oh, come on, Jerry. You know who this is. I told you someone special was visiting us tonight, remember?
It's your cousin Salvatore from Italy.
With my accent, I could hardly be Cousin Salvatore from Italy.
Good heavens, I've been tricked. The man's a Swede.
Tell me, Gene, would you call this fellow an American adult?
Yes, I guess so.
You know, I never shall understand how you chaps did it to us at Bunker Hill.
Bunker Hill? Oh, I get it. The bloke's a Britisher. Hey, tell me, is it true that Big Ben wears elevator shoes?
Cut it out, Jerry. It's about time you were introduced properly. I'm sure you've heard of Mr. Newton.
Newton? Newton? Newton?
Oh, sure. I've been eating his figs.
Jerry, Mr. Newton happens to be one of our greatest actors. Haven't you seen him in a lot of English pictures?
How could I? We don't have a television set. You know? You know, Mr. Newton, we make pictures, too. Right now, one of our pictures is playing in England.
That is precisely why I am in America.
Don't be so uppity. I know lots of English actors. Do you know that husband and wife team, Lawrence Olivier and Vivian Lux?
Why, it's unbelievable.
I'll wager he refers to our Prime Minister as the Honorable Winston Cheesecake.
I'm only kidding honest, Mr. Newton. I really got a lot of respect for you. Really, I have. As a matter of fact, I'd love to be in an English picture with you.
Like Oliver Twist?
Well, why not give it a try tonight? Charles Dickens is past caring, and I've always wanted to play the part of Fagin.
All righty.
And now, let's go back to England in the 1800s. Our scene is a miserable street, in a miserable district, in a miserable suburb of London. There, sitting on a curb, is a miserable little boy.
My name is Oliver Twist, it is. Me mother disappeared the day I was born. She took one look at me and that did it. Since then, I've been working on me own. The first year, I worked 16 hours a day, just changing myself. When I was 10, I'd walked 60 miles to London. I would have taken the streetcar, only it was in Hollywood making a movie. Streetcar, you know. Now I'm in London, cold and alone. Oi, who's this shifty bloke stepping over to me?
Hello, my lad. What's your name?
They call me Oliver Twister.
Twister? That's a funny name.
Dad wanted a pretzel. I beg your pardon, sir. How come they call you the Artful Dodger?
How do you know I was the Artful Dodger?
I read the book.
You look hungry, Oliver. Why don't you eat?
I can't afford it, sir.
I know an old man who'll give you board and lodgings for nothing. Name is Fagin, it is.
Where does he live, sir?
Just follow me right up these steps. I'll give the special knock. He's not in.
Let me try, sir.
Who's knocking?
It's me. It's me, the Artful Dodger.
Who've you got with you?
The door's closed. How'd you know someone was with me?
I read the book, too.
Oh. Well, Oliver, this is Fagin.
Yes, boy. That's me, Fagin. They call me Fagin. Kind Fagin. Generous Fagin. That's me, boy. Fagin.
Fagin? Hey, Fagin, me boy. This is Oliver Twist, eh?
Twist? Twist, that's a funny name.
All right, Dad wanted a corkscrew.
Enough of this petty idiocy. I can't stand it. Fie on. Fie. Foul. Foul.
You left one out.
Which one is that?
Fair.
Tell me, Oliver, what do you think of our little home here?
Hey, you got pigs in here. I ain't sleeping with no dirty pigs, eh?
Oh, don't let it trouble you, boy. They'll get used to you.
Oliver's hungry, Fagin, and he ain't got no money.
Ah, oh, well, cheer up, Oliver. From now on, the yeats are on old Fagin.
If I may be poor, sir, but when I eats off a table.
All right, Oliver. You like cheesecake?
Sure. Oh, sure, sir. He's the best prime minister we ever had.
While we all go out to untwist Oliver, let's listen to the good advice of Jimmy Wallington.
Thank you, Dean. Ladies and gentlemen, every day you hear more and more about an incredibly fast way to relieve the pains of headache, neuritis, and neuralgia. It's Anacin. A-N-A-C-I-N. Now, the reason Anacin is so wonderfully fast-acting and effective is this. Anacin is like a doctor's prescription. That is, Anacin contains not just one, but a combination of medically proven active ingredients in easy-to-take tablet form. Thousands of people have received envelopes containing Anacin tablets from their own dentist or physician, and in this way discovered the incredibly fast relief Anacin brings from pains of headache, neuritis, or neuralgia. So the next time a headache strikes, take Anacin. A-N-A-C-I-N. Anacin in handy boxes of 12 and 30. Economical family-sized bottles of 50 and 100. Ask for Anacin at any drug counter.
When a lyric writer with 500 songs to his credit picks out one of his all-time greatest, chances are that it's a pretty powerful song, such as the case with Leo Robin, who was asked by Ralph Ranger to write a lyric for a tune of his. And the end result was a song that will always be considered an all-time great. So, with your kind permission.
It's June in January, because I'm in love. It always is spring in my heart with you in my arms. The snow is just white blossoms that fall from above. And here is the reason, my dear, your magical charm. the night is cold. The trees are bare, but I can feel the scent of roses in the air. It's June in January, because I'm in love, but only because I'm in love with you. The night is cold, the trees are bare, but I can feel the scent of roses in the air. It's you. Because I'm in love, but only because I'm in love with you.
January.
Pardon me for intruding, but I'd like to say goodnight, please.
Well, Mr. Newton, we certainly enjoyed having you as a guest.
Yeah, you really surprised me. Everyone said that English people have a slower sense of humor than us, and it took a long time to get jokes. But you were laughing all through the show. You thought we were pretty funny, huh, Mr. Newton?
Well, I'm afraid I won't be able to answer that for a few days. Tonight I was laughing at last Tuesday's Bob Hope show.
Good night, and thanks for being such a good sport.
Good night, boy.
Before we leave tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to say something both serious and important. On our last television show and radio program, we talked about the dread disease muscular dystrophy. Your response was so wonderful that we would like to mention it over and over again. Muscular dystrophy is a disease for which there is no known cause or cure, striking young and old alike and ending in death. The only way we can lick this terrible disease is through further research, and the only way this research can be continued is your contributions. As Dean said previously, if only every listener would send 1 cent, it would go a long way toward continued research and a possible cure. Please send a little something tonight. Mail your contribution to MDA, 21 East 40th Street, New York City. That's MDA, 21 East 40th Street, New York City, New York.
Good night, everybody.
Night.
From Hollywood, you have just heard transcribed the Dean Martin and Jerry Lewis Show, written by Ed Simmons and Norman Lear, produced and directed by Dick Beck, with music under the direction of Dick Stabile. Brought to you by Dentine, the gum with breathtaking flavor, by Bemis Pepsin, the gum that's great to chew and good for your digestion, too, by Chesterfield. Sound off for Chesterfield. Get something new, something no other cigarette has. Chesterfield mildness, plus no unpleasant aftertaste. And by Anacin, for fast relief from pain of headache, neuritis, and neuralgia. The role of John Newton was portrayed tonight by Mr. Hans Conreid.
This is NBC, the National Broadcasting Company.